hello, friends, and welcome to a Worship on Wheels. If things look a little different, it's because I have a special guest here today. So Coach Vic is making a debut appearance on Worship on Wheels today. It's funny. She's here for a purpose. No, she's not going to say anything, and she's more than eye candy. Although she is eye candy. You know, so many times we think in life that we can just please God. We can just please Him, that we can do the right things, and He's going to go, way to go, boy. All right? That's not really how it works. I hope that doesn't disappoint you. I hope that you don't think, you know, so many people go, well, I'm a good person, and that's why God's going to like me. So what I want to explain today is that God is perfect. So if we've told one lie, we are, in fact, a liar. If we've stolen one thing, we are a thief. And those, you know, when you start looking at things in the scale of perfection, all or nothing, right? Man, that can be real scary. And it should be scary to us. That's how it's supposed to be. Now, the Bible says this. It says that the beginning of knowledge is the fear of God. In other words, that's when you realize, you go, uh-oh, I'm in big trouble here. I can't please Him. I can't do it right. I can't get it all right. So I'm messed up. I'm struggling. I'm a sinner. I've told a lie. I've stolen something. I've said something ugly about a friend of mine. I've manipulated. I've cheated, or any of those things that we do as human beings. And you know what? We all do them to a certain degree. We all do them to a certain level. So I'm not here to act like that I'm all holier than thou, because guess what? I'm not. I am absolutely not. But the reason I have Coach Vic here today is that, you know, when I first met her, I was a little afraid. I was a little afraid. I was afraid because of that wheelchair. It scared me, y'all. It did. I'd buried a wife from cancer, and that thing scared me. And I was mortified. And then as I loved her, all of the fear just disappeared. And that painted such a beautiful picture of my relationship with God. You know, it says that perfect love casts out fear. In other words, when you're in love with God, then you don't have to be afraid anymore, because you're going to be forgiven. You're going to follow Him. You're going to chase Him. You're going to seek Him out. Jeremiah says, if you look for me with all your heart, you'll find me, right? He's here to give us a hope and a peace. He's the all-knowing God, man. He knows already. There's a song by a guy named Grover Levy, and it goes like this. It says, I don't want to be lyrical. I don't want to be magical. I could never be logical. I just want to be so in love with you. That's what we need to be. We need to be in love with our Father. In fact, you know, the Bible says that we can approach the throne of grace boldly and cry out, Abba, Father, which means Daddy. We can be so close to Him that we can call Him Daddy. You know, it's amazing that we can be in love with someone that created all of this. Everything we're looking at. And all of this, and all of my weakness, and all of my frailty, God created me, and He loves me, and I love Him, and I seek Him, and I want Him to love me, because I love Him. And likewise, I love Coach Vic, and she loves me. And the more I love her with reckless abandon and chase her, the more she loves me. And the more I chase God with reckless abandon, the more He will too love me. I just want to be loved by you. Well, I hope that you know, my friends, that you are loved, and so am I. And that God has you. He has you. He has you covered. You know, the verse last week said that Jesus, that we couldn't, you can't, no one can snatch you from His hand. Should encourage you. It's called security. And you can be secure in your faithful love to your daddy. All right. Now, my friends, I want you to do me a favor. I want you to go out, change the world. We'll talk to you real soon.